हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वेलकम बैक टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री, चैप्टर 7, एजुकेशन एंड कॉलोनियल रूल, दैट वी कैन कॉल द ब्रिटिश रूल एज वेल. सो वी विल लर्न हाउ द एजुकेशन सिस्टम हैज़ बीन चेंज, हाउ द संस्कृत सिस्टम, द श्लोक सिस्टम्स एंड द मॉडर्न एजुकेशन वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस इन इंडिया. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड. हियर आई स्टार्ट. द टॉपिक इज एजुकेशन सिस्टम बिफोर द ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया. Now, before the British rule, education was imparted through a chain of elementary schools, pathshalas, maktabs and madrasas for higher education. Means it was for totally religion biased. Then the education provided in such institutions were based on old texts like Vedas and their commentaries, where the Hindus used to go for the studies and the education. Then, but when British put steps in India, the education system suffered a lot. And East India Company loses interest in the education. Now the next point, introduction of Western education. Now Western education was led by following causes. Number one, East India Company, and number two, Christian missionaries. Now I told you na, ki East India Company was wanting, the Britishers were wanting that the all the religions should turn up themselves in the Christianity and they will get some kind of benefits. All right. So and East India Company was introducing the Western culture, the modern education. So they were playing the important role. Now the next heading is introduction of Western education, the East India Company. Now English East India Company showed a very little interest in the promotion of education in India. And the number two, the purpose of these institutes is to supply the steady education about the law and establish a classical language. That is knowledge. All right. Now, what East India Company was wanting, they were actually introducing the modern world, the Western education. And there was the people, Muslim, who used to get study for the madrasas. And the Hindu religions were studies in the Vedic education. So now the things were like that. The East India Company was wanting that now they should study for the Western education as well. Now there were some topics like some first educational institutes in the East India Company, how the first introduced the first institutes were open. So the number one is the Calcutta Madrasa, then the number two is Sanskrit College, and number three is Fort William College. Now let's go and study about it. Now the Calcutta Madrasa was set up in 1781 in Calcutta only, and it was set up by Warren Hastings. And the purpose was just to for the study of Muslim law related subject. Like nowadays also there is a madrasa where only Muslim you can go and study themselves. Now their first priority was ki the study of Muslim law related subject should be studied. Okay. Then the next topic is the Sanskrit College. It was set up in 1791 in Benares, which is now came to be known as Kashi or Varanasi. Then it was set up by Jonathan Duncan and was the purpose by for the study of Hindu law and philosophy. Like if you go to Kashi or Varanasi, you will find so many Sanskrit colleges there, and there the education is very good and excellent. And it was mainly made for the purpose to for the Hindus to get the study as well their philosophy. Next topic is Fort William College. It was set up in Calcutta again in 1800. It was set up by Lord Wellesley. The purpose for the training of the civil servants of the company in language and customs of the Indians. It was open for all, not for Hindu, not for Muslim, not for Christian, not for anyone. It was open for all the civil servants, for everybody, for all the Indians especially. Next is Christian missionaries. Activists of Christian missionaries compelled the British to promote Western education in India. Obviously, when Western education was there, so much of Christian missionaries like the British East India Company was promoting the missionaries school and as well. So now this also happened and this was also introduced. And then it was main English missionaries, number one, who was there? Charles Grant and William Wilberforce. All right. Because Charles Grant, known as the father of modern education. Then number two, the Character Act of 1831 is established due to his struggle. Alright, the Charles Grant is the father of modern education. Then it was established and he has struggled a lot. And number three, according to this act, 1 lakh rupees was donated to improve the education system. At that time, 1 lakh rupees is equivalent to 100 crores today. And he put more stress, invest in education and open number of schools and colleges for high classes families. And the Character Act fails afterwards. It was actually failed. Now, Wood Dispatch in 1854. Number one, he proposed the first comprehensive plan for the promotion of Western education. Number two, he also gave importance to primary schools and presented all institutes in hierarchy such as primary, middle, high, college and university. Number three, he made English compulsory in higher education and local languages at school level. Number four, he gave training to teachers and promote women education too. Then open universities in Calcutta, Madras and Bombay. And then he made it compulsory that education institutes was run by European headmasters as well the principals. Now here I am discussing the last topic, growth of national education 1906. Number one, Indian national leaders formed a National Council of Education. Number two, Central Hindu School in Benares established by Annie Besant in July 1898. Number three, Mohabbatein Anglo-Oriental College or MAO in Aligarh was established by Syed Ahmad Khan in 1875 and later on university. Number four, National Muslim School by Syed Ahmad Braveli. Number five, New English School 1880s in Bombay was founded by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Then the first women university was established by Dhonde Keshav Karve in Pune in 1916. It is the first women university that was set up. And then Bordha University also came into existence in 1949 after a very long struggle. So now the chapter is ended. Kindly be home, at home, be safe, take yourself and goodbye. Thank you.